Et bienvenue tout le monde, nous sommes ici à Le Shtick avec Serge Thomann.
Bonjour Henri.
Ça va mon ami?
Très bien, et toi?
That was enough French for the moment because most of our viewers don't know French.
Vous avez know bonjour.
Oh bonjour.
And easy. Maybe a couple of other expressions that we can't say on air.
Comme quoi?
Well, you know, there's a song. Voulez-vous?
Voulez-vous coucher avec moi? Tout le monde connaît ça. We're here to celebrate a very dear friend of yours who passed away last year. And her name is Mirka Mora.
Mirka Madeleine Mora, yes.
Yeah. What's the right way to say Mirka? Because I've heard...
Mirka.
Mirka. Correct.
Mirka.
Mirka.
And you know, there's only one other Mirka I've met.
Really? One other?
Roger Federer's wife is Mirka.
Mirka.
And I always wanted to get the two together because Mirka actually loved tennis, but I've never managed to get them together.
Well, I've always liked French things. I have to mention the word francophile. I am, since I was 7 years old, I was actually only six at the time. We left Israel and we went via France and Germany on the way to Australia. And my first impression of Paris just blew me away. I was actually in the south of France first, and that was the countryside there. That was the Vincent van Gogh kind of country.
Yes.
Beautiful.
Yes.
Land.
And then it's called Luberon.
Luberon. Where we were at Aix-en-Provence.
Yes.
And but Paris is something that has always hit me, you know, inside.
Paris is a beautiful city, obviously. Mm. It's not quite the same that it used to be because of what happened at Notre Dame. But, there's a lot of money has been pledged to refurbish it.
Mirka and George arrived here in Melbourne in the early 50s. Yeah,
1951, yes.
Yes, the year I came into the world. See, I've just given away my age. God, I can't believe I'm...
You don't look it.
No, I don't
feel
it.
Especially with a hat.
I feel about 42. Well, this was one of Mirka's favourite hats. We had a relationship. And I really...
I'm not surprised.
She always wanted to sleep with me, but I always thought she was too old for me.
That's not true.
She wanted to sleep with everybody because she was so...
She was encouraging, but she never did.
Never did, that's right.
But you know what she keeps saying?
She was a flirt.
She was a flirt, but her husband... didn't have a problem with that. And he said, you can have affairs, but you can't get involved.
C'est ça. So true. You were known as the fourth son of Mirka.
Yeah, Mirka sometimes described me as their fourth son. And I certainly have done a lot of things for... I treated her like my Aussie mum. And my mum is very shy and reserved, the total opposite of Mirka.
Total opposite.
So my mum, when it's my mum's birthday, she stays at home and da-da-da. I can't even take them out for dinner. Mirka, she want to have parties and things. So I've organized her 80th, 85th, and her 90th birthday party where she was still, you know, about 3 or 4 months before she died, and she was still in good spirit. You know, it's only after her birthday where sort of her health went down. But and I also organized a Marcel Marceau to give her to make her officier des arts et des lettres.
Recognized and that French brings government. Us to your great honor that you only received recently. What date was that?
But I was nominated in May last year, but I got it on the 7th of March, yes.
7th of March this year. At Alliance Française?
No, at Raheen.
Oh, Raheen, of course. With
yes,
the great
had Miss Pratt.
Jeannie Pratt was
Jeannie
there.
Jeannie Pratt, but she hosted my party, so...
And Rachel Griffiths was there. Rachel, your
friend. Yes, but I had...
Friend.
What obviously, it was... I became a Chevalier de l'Ordre National du Mérite, which is like the French equivalent of an Order of Australia, for services to the community and the French... in general, but also the community at large. But I have involved a lot of my friends, celebrity friends, to do things for the Alliance Française, for the French Film Festival, for the, you know, when the Australian Rule French team comes and stuff. So I was trying to have at my party people who meant something to me as part of that journey of getting this achievement. So I had Sam Gilbert from... the Saints, because he actually got the French Australian rule team into the
water, the World Cup
in the middle of winter.
Yep.
Because I don't think the French would have gone by themselves. So I had Sam to direct them. You know, I had Rachel Griffiths, who is a friend, but also she's done hosted a couple of dinners or things for the French Film Festival. I had Molly Meldrum got me arrested in Paris, and she wasn't very happy. I
told another that story. So, that's a good story.
Yeah, I was telling in front of the French ambassador that I bribed the French public servants. That was interesting. But so, and obviously, Mirka. I've done a lot of things for Mirka, and especially I got her to be recognized by the French government for what she has done for France in Australia and for arts in general around the world.
And it's more about the culture. The culture that her and George brought together, and the arts.
But I think Mirka, what Mirka was doing next to painting, in fact, her painting was overshadowed by her showing her tits and her ass at every possible opportunity. And in a way, you know, I don't know, hopefully I'm not being too irreverent, but
Mirka, okay.
She did flash her tits at one of my fundraising lunch at François, and she did say that she's only sucked one politician's cock, but she didn't tell me who it was. I know it was in Sydney. But, you know, she was a very, very unique.
Promiscuous.
And
we're going to see a little bit as we go out of her youngest son, the little baby Willie.
No, it's the second.
Second? Who's the youngest?
Tyrell.
Oh, Tyrell. Of course, Tyrell is younger. Material, anyway, got them out of order.
Yes, she's got three.
I know.
But I'm the youngest. I'm the youngest.
You're the youngest of the four. But we'll speak about them later. But we're just going to have a little clip of the event where we were on Sunday at the Heide Museum.
Yes. So Heide, obviously, George started, like, John and Sonia Reeds and adopted Mirka and George into their family, and they spent a lot of time there back in the 50s.
We'll stop you there because we're going to come back and you can tell us more, because we're ending the segment here. We'll be back after the break with the special on Mirka Mora with Serge Thomann. Thanks, Serge.
One of my earliest memories is being in that room watching one of the first televisions in black and white, watching Disneyland and Father Knows Best. When actually hung around us was Ned Kelly's Nolan paintings. We had no idea the importance they would assume in Australia's fabulous art history. Meanwhile, our parents were in the dining room adjacent to the kitchen talking about all things French art, poetry, love, food, etc. We were watching Father Knows Best in the library when suddenly the window would fling open and Sweeney Reed would leap in his Superman suit, hold us down and fart on our heads. So I had sort of not such artistic memories of Heide in those early days. Look, well, I could go on telling stories for hours, but I just wanted to really say how truly moved we are that this has really happened so quickly. And For us personally to see Mirka in a very tangible way now included in the group of what is known as Australia's modern artists, not just this eccentric bohemian who would flash her breasts at any opportunity. So for us, we feel she's found her true artistic place at home, at Heide, which has been so much part of our lives. And I'll just end by saying I really think now that the spirits of Heide have a new tenant. Thank you very much.